Hey, so I'm out here in the yard in the hammock before it gets too hot. It says it's supposed to be 99 today. And you look at me and I'm wearing a jacket, yes. Anyways, I'm just like probably most all you guys where you have temperature regulation issues. It's cooler in the house. If the air conditioner's on, I have to wear a jacket in the house too, and I always have to wear socks unless it's hot outside because I've lost circulation in my hands and feet, so they're always cold. So I want to talk about a few things today. Bras, it's been years. You can ask my friends online. I've been asking about bras. I've been trying on bras, trying to find a bra that's comfortable, but they all hurt. They all just give me pain and even headaches. You know, that pain back here with the myalgic encephalomyelitis. And so I was researching going braless in hopes that I could find what kind of clothes, you know, and stuff. It may sound ridiculous, but I'm a D. Or double D. I don't know exactly if I'm a D or double D because I lost weight, and I'm at a particular age, and these are natural, without saying too much. After all my research, I found what I've been doing is my best option, and this is the only thing that I really spend money on, and this is tank tops, bra, you know, with the bras inside the bra tops, and it's called Best Love Cami, and they're on Express. You go Express online, Best Love Cami, and this is the bra top that's called Best Love Cami, and they're on sale right now, but the colors are limited. You pay $19.99 for one, and the second one's half price, so that's what I do, and I buy as many as I can each year, which is usually two to four, because I wear them every day, and now the bras, I'm giving up, I'm not wearing them. Now I have this shirt on without a bra, right? And it's fine, but remember, I'm big, so I mean, I don't want to look. You know, like, you know, I don't want to look National Geographic. I just want to be comfortable. And also, Utah, I was born Mormon, and here it's not acceptable to go without bras, but I can't take it. It's too painful. I'm mostly housebound and yardbound anyways, but so I just have cheap bras that I wear underneath here. Or I just am gonna layer it like this to go out. I've gone out every once in a while without a bra, but I mean, I have to support. It just makes me look more flat, not wearing a bra. It's the whole nipple thing, I guess, too, that people sexualize it. I don't know. But all I know is for my health, with the pain and stuff from the bras. And they don't fit right, and then with the heat underneath, and I can't do it. I'm not gonna do it anymore, so it's gonna be interesting. But since I'm mostly house and yard bound, it hasn't been a big issue so far. But I, in the past, when someone stopped by to visit, even if I was wearing the bra top, I would still cover up here because that's just the way I was raised. But you see, I mean, I had this one on this morning without anything, and this is the bra tops that I get, and they have the shelf bra in here, and these last forever. And I mean, I'm serious, they last years. And you know, I'm outside a lot. They'll fade. If you use a good laundry detergent, they don't fade as much. But I'm outside a lot. Mostly in the shade, but sometimes working in the yard. And so Yeah, they'll fade, and then I'm guilty of getting some paint on some. I'm trying to just keep those that have paint on them for when I'm painting, though, instead of ruining the good ones. So, yeah, it may sound crazy that you have to research something like going braless, but from where I come from, it's such a taboo thing that it's like, but it is lots of pain. And, oh, that's what I bring out with me when I come outside. So, right now, I buy the powdery powder, the big can. I think I've showed you guys I get it from Amazon, and it's a really good price, actually. And then I just put it in, I save Powerade bottles or Gatorade bottles. Alright. So this is a bag that my daughter had. I like it. It has Tinkerbell on. It's Disney. I have whatever book I'm reading. My earmuffs. See, hear those dogs? I have my composition book to write anything I think of because my brain's everywhere. I have an extra book in case this one gets boring. I'm not sure if I'm gonna like this one or not because it might be too trekky for me. I'm not sure. We'll see. I don't know. And then I have my MP3 player in there, an extra bookmark, pencil, pen, and my homemade lip balm. I make my own lip balm. So that's what's in my bag today. And then these hammocks here. The most difficult part was figuring out how to hang them. And duct tape wouldn't work, and neither would belling wire. So that's actually a dog tie-up thing that I've used there. Because I don't have a dog, and I don't believe in tying them up anyways. And I had it laying around. And then I ordered another swing chain. You know, the chains that the swings hang from. And this hammock I got at Winco for less than $10. It was just $9.99 or something. And then they've got the hammock swing there, which you sit in, but you can kind of curl up in. The grandbabies usually fall asleep in my lap in that chair. And then we got the pillows to go with it. So, and then a lot of people like laying on my trampoline. Oh, and a lot of people sit on the bottom of the slide, and then I got some other seating, but I haven't figured out how to make this look nice, because I don't know where else to put the firewood. The firewood's what makes it look junky. I don't know where else to put it. I'm going to talk to my son and see if we can figure out someplace else. Put it so I can make it look kind of nice here. Alright. So, we had the going braless discussion. We've had the hammock and what's in my bag discussion. So, that pretty much covers it all that I can think of right now. So, that's my vlog for this week. I'm going to put everything back in my bag and I'm going to lay out here and read until it gets too hot. And then I'll go in. And then that's when I'll upload this video, most likely. Oh, I just thought of the one other thing. So we canceled paying for any TV, like Dish or Xfinity and stuff. Because it's ridiculous. And you got Hulu and you got Netflix and you got the internet. So why do you really need TV? And we had all these TV antennas sitting around here. So we canceled. We have the internet, and then we have Netflix, and we have Hulu. And we canceled the TV, which was like $250. or something ridiculous. I wasn't paying it. I wouldn't pay that. Hell no. And we're using the antenna now. Whoop, whoop. And that's another good thing. So, but we just haven't figured out the antenna to get all the channels right now. 2 is the channel that's coming in. But that's good enough for news and stuff. Anything else you can look up on the internet, huh? Alright, and oh, on Hulu, I can watch Preacher. I can watch my AMC shows. At least that's what my friend Pearl told me. And I trust Pearl. She's more techie savvy and everything than me. I'm not. I need major help. Alright, now I've covered everything. Now I'm done. Alright, guys, hugs and loves. Have the best week that you can. And try to enjoy the little things. And I'm here for you if you need me. Alright, bye.